that's something that we have to always remember. And I will show you the statistics from Google's website, the transparency report. It's from Egypt. And you can see very clearly the dead here. These are the 5 days of the revolution. I'll zoom in on it. These days are the days of the revolution. They just put the plug. They can put the plug. When they actually reach a point where they think they're losing the battle online, they'll just put the plug. They don't have to use the remote. So that's why, I'm just trying to to give a sobering point of view about this state that we are using, not being, all black or all white. I'll end this by giving a very similar example that happened 100 years ago. There was an amazing new technology called the phone. And at that time, there were academic papers and activists who claimed that the nation state will end, that transportation will end, that people will just sit home and talk to each other. Why get out of the house when you have a telephone? It's like so amazing, And that the telephone will change governments, telephones. Now, we we're telephone natives, I would call this crowd. We grew up with telephones. We think of telephone as a, media, social media. Like the government can use it, we can use it, has good things, has bad things. And I think Twitter and Facebook is very similar to this situation. Just to give you an example of my take on all of the Arab revolutions, the Arab Spring, is that these revolutions happen because Arabs reached to a point where they needed to have revolutions. Now, what the tools that they used, whether they used a phone or Twitter account or shouted from their balcony, that's not really the story. And just to prove this, one way to prove this is that Iraq had one of the most intense demonstrations, more intense than many other countries in the Arab world. The internet penetration in Iraq is 2%. As opposed to 85% and 90% in other Arab countries. 2%. And Iraqis organized the demonstrations by sending SMS messages and MMS messages from their phones, mostly. A little bit online. There was one Iraqi Facebook page that I actually know the people behind it. It has 50,000 people on it, which is a big number for a country like Iraq, where the entire online population is a million, Iraq managed to do it, and they don't have Twitter. They don't really use Twitter as much, but they don't have internet connectivity. So my point is that it is more complicated than having the tool. It requires having the will. It requires reaching to the perfect store where people are ready for change, and they have the will to actually go down to the streets. Let me stop here, and I'm sure we'll discuss more things later.